this project, you will see a tutorial of a coil gun which is powerful enough to break glass bottles and can shoot over 10 meters by creating 238 joules of energy with 415 volts and can charge with batteries or main AC power supply and can load 3 bullets in the magazine. And for the targeting system, it has 3 lasers which is similar to the Predator. So I started to make the coil gun by this Fujifilm disposable camera. I simply opened it just by using bare hands. Then I took the circuit and desoldered some unnecessary components including the flash and the switch. I soldered the switch which used to charge the capacitor. Then I simply replaced some components with wires including the battery, the capacitor and the LED. I did the same things with another circuit, then I covered everything with tape and connected the input and output wires in parallel, except the LEDs. Then I covered everything with tape again. Then I moved into the barrel part. The barrel is 13 inch long and 1 cm in diameter. To make it cooler, I cut one of the end of the barrel in 16 degrees and used sandpaper to make it smooth. Then I started to make space for an ammo loader. Then I cut a little bit more. I used this simple door lock to make the ammo loader. I simply took the main thing out of its casing. Then I inserted, marked it and cut it by using a hacksaw. Then sanded it and it looked like this. I actually made a mistake by cutting here. To solve this problem, I used a superglue and piece of paper. I simply wrapped the paper and used superglue and sandpaper. And here are some measurements. Then I started to wind the coil. I made 10 layers of coil. And yeah, that's the same casing that I used in my Mark 1 coil gun. Then I used hot glue and placed the barrel thing. Then I glued 2 pieces of popsicle. Then I insert the ammo loader. And by the way, that's a neodymium magnet. This allows the projectile to stay in place. I use super glue as well as hot glue. And that's 6 amp and 260 volt rated toggle switch. Like before, I used hot glue again to hold it in place. And these are 2 AA 4 cell battery holders. This time I just used screws instead of hot glue for no reason, cause I'm a genius. This switch is also high current and voltage rated. The hot glue again, and I used another switch like that. The first one will allow the caps to charge on batteries, and the second one will charge the caps on AC voltage, I mean main power supply. I used 8 of these 450 volts and 330 UF rated capacitors. By using hot glue, I simply attached the capacitors and connected the terminal in parallel. And then the whole thing was attached to the main body. I used 6 AIO diodes to make a rectifier, cause capacitors can't be charged on AC. I got this part from an old PC power supply. Then I soldered the AC side of the rectifier to that thing and added wires and simply screwed in place. Then I did some connections with the batteries and switches. I used 3 lasers of 5 milliwatt. I used the thread and super glue to make it stable. I soldered 2 blue LEDs in parallel and placed it under the coil and hot glued it. When everything was assembled, I connected all the things according to the circuit diagram. Then I did the first test on 428 volts. By the way, the projectile's length is 2.5 centimeters. Then I loaded the ammo for the first test and it was incredible. Then I did some couple other tests to make sure it works perfectly. I did some connections to the lasers, then I started to make the battery holder. Then I glued the wires and simply connected it. I used 3-volt lithium cell batteries to power the lasers. I use 2 batteries because 1 isn't enough. And it works. The idea of 3 lasers I actually got from Predator movie. I use these glue sticks to protect me from getting shocked. I used this binding post, which is directly connected to the capacitor bank. I used some kind of plastic sheet to cover the diodes and wires. Obviously, you need this cable to charge the capacitors. With main power supply, it just takes a few minutes to charge the capacitors. And with the help of 8 AA batteries, it takes 6 minutes to charge 430 volts. And the last test was to check the range. It's not that much, but it shoots over 10 meters. Which is probably better than my previous coil gun. Just look where I was shooting. The last thing was to do to make a magazine. To make that, I used 2 pieces of plastic scales of 4 centimeters. Then I sanded the pieces. Taped those together and used mini hand drill. Then I used this 4 centimeter long piece of popsicle to cover the sides with superglue. And it was done. Then I cut the popsicle pieces like this in order to fit on the barrel. I used super glue first and then used hot glue. Then I made this simple thing to hold the bullets in the magazine. I used rubber band and this thing to hold that thing. Load the bullets and do this, and here we go. So that's all for now. Please like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Talk to you then.